ఇంటర్మీడియట్ విద్యా రంగంలో అగ్రగామి మన ఎన్ఎస్ఆర్ ఇంపల్స్ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూషన్ ఐఐటి జేఈఈ అయినా నీట్ అయినా తిరుగులేని విద్యా సంస్థ ఎన్ఎస్ఆర్ ఇంపల్స్.
Whereas in alveoli PCO2 is 40 mmHg, in oxygenated blood partial pressure of oxygen is CO2 is also 40 mmHg, in deoxygenated blood partial pressure of oxygen is 40 mmHg, partial pressure of carbon dioxide is 45 mmHg. In the tissue also PO2 is 40 mmHg, PCO2 is 45 mmHg. Specifically in the case of the deoxygenated blood as well as in deoxygenated blood as well as in tissue, partial pressure of oxygen as well as the partial pressure of carbon dioxide are same. In deoxygenated blood PO2 is 40 mmHg, in tissue also PO2 is 40 mmHg. In deoxygenated blood PCO2 is 45, in tissue also that is 45. Means in deoxygenated blood as well as in tissue, partial pressure of oxygen as well as the partial pressure of carbon dioxide are same. Very important questions in NEET examination point of view. What is the partial pressure difference of oxygen? What is the partial pressure difference of oxygen between the oxygenated and deoxygenated blood? What is the partial pressure difference of oxygen? This is the partial pressure of oxygen. Partial pressure difference of oxygen between the oxygenated and deoxygenated blood is approximately 55, because 95 minus 40, that is 55 mmHg is partial pressure difference of respiratory gases, partial pressure difference of oxygen between the oxygenated blood and deoxygenated blood. So by basing this, we can derive very few important NEET questions, very important NEET objective questions from this table are: one is, what is partial pressure difference of oxygen between oxygenated and deoxygenated blood? Oxygenated and deoxygenated blood means, what is the partial pressure of oxygen in oxygenated blood? 95 mmHg. What is the partial pressure of oxygen in deoxygenated blood? 40. So difference is 95 minus 40, that equal to 55 mmHg, is the partial pressure difference of oxygen between the pulmonary vein and pulmonary artery, or systemic artery and systemic vein, or oxygenated and deoxygenated blood. Similarly, next question, what is the partial pressure difference of respiratory gases between the oxygenated blood? What is the partial pressure difference of respiratory gases in oxygenated blood? Or what is the partial pressure difference of respiratory gases in deoxygenated blood? Definitely What is the partial pressure difference of respiratory gases? O2 and CO2 are the respiratory gases. What is the partial pressure difference of PO2 and PCO2 in oxygenated blood? Nothing but PO2 is 95 mmHg, PCO2 is 40 mmHg. What is the difference between these? Also 55 mmHg. Next question is that, what is partial pressure? Partial pressure difference of respiratory gases in oxygenated blood. What is the partial pressure difference of respiratory gases in oxygenated blood means? Partial pressure of oxygen in oxygenated blood is 95 mmHg. Partial pressure of carbon dioxide is 40 mmHg. What is the difference between these two? Is nothing but 95 minus 40, that equal to 55 mmHg. Is the partial pressure difference of respiratory gases in oxygenated blood. Similarly, questions may be asked from this table. You should, by heart, you should remember what is the partial pressure of oxygen in atmosphere means 159 mmHg. Partial pressure of carbon dioxide in atmosphere is 0.3 mmHg. Similarly, PO2 in alveoli is 104. CO2 is 40, oxygenated blood PO2 is 95 mmHg, PCO2 is 40 mmHg, in deoxygenated blood or in pulmonary artery or in systemic vein, PO2 is 40 mmHg, PCO2 is 45 mmHg, in tissue PO2 is 40, PCO2 is 45 mmHg. Again, exchange of respiratory gases principally occurs at two sites. One is the at lung, second one is at tissue. The exchange of respiratory gases, exchange of O2 and CO2 near the lung is said to be as the pulmonary exchange, and exchange of the respiratory gases near the tissue is said to be as the systemic exchange. Exchange of respiratory gases nothing but exchange of oxygen and CO2 between the lungs and blood or between the blood and tissue is said to be as the exchange of respiratory gases. Exchange of respiratory gases principally occurs at two sites. One is the at lung, second one is the at tissue. Definitely, exchange of respiratory gases either near the lung or near the tissue is occurs by simple diffusion. Definitely, exchange of respiratory gases, are occurs at two sites. One is near the lung, that is the pulmonary exchange. Second one is near the tissue, that is the systemic exchange. This is also called as external respiration. This is also called as internal respiration. This is the internal respiration. exchange of respiratory gases always occurs at two sites. One is near the lung, that is said to be as the pulmonary exchange or external respiration. Second, near the tissue, that is said to be as the systemic exchange or internal respiration. Whether it is a systemic, whether it is a pulmonary exchange at either near the lung or near the tissue, exchange of the respiratory gases is occurs by the simple diffusion. Means by basing partial pressure difference, this exchange of the respiratory gases is taken place. By basing the partial pressure difference, this exchange of the respiratory gases is taken place. Means from higher partial pressured area to lower partial pressured area, either oxygen or CO2 is gets more. Simple diffusion, nothing but hence this respiratory gases are gets more. Means from higher partial pressured area to lower partial pressured area, either oxygen or CO2 is gets moves. Then when we observe the first, that is the pulmonary exchange. How this pulmonary exchange is occurs means just assume this is the alveoli, this is the pulmonary capillary, this is nothing but alveoli, this is the pulmonary capillary. In the pulmonary capillary, what is the blood which is circulated? Means deoxygenated blood is circulated. So that only in pulmonary capillary, what is the PO2, what is the PCO2 in pulmonary capillary? Means PO2 equal to 40 mmHg, PCO2 equal to 45 mmHg. In the case of the pulmonary capillary, deoxygenated blood is circulated but not oxygenated blood. In deoxygenated blood, partial pressure of oxygen is 40 mmHg, partial pressure of carbon dioxide is 45 mmHg. Similarly, in the case of the alveoli, PO2 equal to 104 mmHg, PCO2 equal to 40 mmHg. So definitely respiratory gases always moves from its higher partial pressured area to lower partial pressured area. Here in alveoli, oxygen partial pressure is 104. In deoxygenated blood such as the pulmonary capillary, PO2 is only 40 mmHg. So that only from the alveoli, oxygen is gets moves into the pulmonary capillary. Means from the higher partial pressured area to lower partial pressured area, oxygen is gets moves, oxygen is gets diffuses. Similarly, CO2 partial pressure in deoxygenated blood is 45, in alveoli that is 40. So that only CO2 also gets moves from the higher partial pressured area to lower partial pressured area. Means definitely CO2 is gets diffuses from the deoxygenated blood into the alveoli. Oxygen is diffuses from the alveoli into the deoxygenated blood. In that way, depending upon the partial pressure difference near the lung between the alveoli and the pulmonary capillary, oxygen as well as CO2 exchange is taken place. That is said to be as the pulmonary exchange. What is the significance of the pulmonary exchange means? Pulmonary exchange always useful for converting of deoxygenated blood into oxygenated blood. Whenever the oxygen from the alveoli reaches to the pulmonary capillary, and whenever the CO2 from the pulmonary capillaries reaches to the alveoli, gradually this CO2 gets removed from the deoxygenated blood. Oxygen is added to that kind of the blood. As a result of this, deoxygenated blood is gradually converted into oxygenated blood. Means oxygen percentage gradually increases, CO2 percentage gradually decreases. This process is nothing but oxygenation. Oxygenation of blood is taken place by this kind of the pulmonary exchange. Pulmonary exchange is also called as the external respiration. Definitely in this case, oxygen from alveoli is reaches into blood of pulmonary capillary. CO2 which is present in the pulmonary capillary is reaches into the alveoli for its expulsion to out. In this particular pulmonary exchange, what is the important need based questions means? In this particular concept, what is the important need based question means? The first question is that, what is the partial pressure difference of oxygen in pulmonary exchange is the first question. What is the partial pressure difference of carbon dioxide in pulmonary exchange is the second question. Third question is that, what is the partial pressure difference of respiratory gases in pulmonary exchange? Three very important questions for NEET examination point of view on this particular concept are, one is the, what is partial pressure difference of oxygen? Partial pressure difference of O2 in pulmonary exchange is the first question. Second, what is partial pressure difference of CO2 in pulmonary exchange? Third question, what is partial pressure difference of respiratory gases in pulmonary exchange? What is the partial pressure difference of oxygen? First question is that, what is the partial pressure difference of O2 in pulmonary exchange? Means PO2 partial pressure of oxygen in the alveoli is 104. Partial pressure of oxygen in pulmonary capillary is 40. So that difference between the 104 and 40 is nothing but answer to the first question. So answer to the first question is 104 minus 40, that equal to 64 mmHg is the partial pressure of pressure difference of oxygen in the pulmonary exchange. Partial pressure difference of oxygen in pulmonary exchange is 104 minus 40, that equal to 64 mmHg. Second question, what is the partial pressure difference of CO2 in pulmonary exchange? What is the partial pressure difference of CO2 in pulmonary exchange means, PCO2 in alveoli is 40, PCO2 in pulmonary capillary is 45. What is the difference between this means 45 minus 40? That equal to 5. answer to the second question is 5 mmHg only. Definitely partial pressure difference of CO2 in pulmonary exchange is 45 minus 40, that is equal to only 5. Third question, what is the partial pressure difference of respiratory gases in pulmonary exchange? Partial pressure difference of oxygen is 64. Partial pressure difference of CO2 is 5. Totally, both partial pressure difference of oxygen and CO2 is nothing but 64 plus 5, that equal to 69 mmHg. Answer to the third question. Total partial pressure difference of respiratory gases in pulmonary exchange means oxygen partial pressure difference is 64 mmHg, CO2 partial pressure difference is 5 mmHg, totally that is 69 mmHg. Answer to the third question, total partial pressure difference of respiratory gases and pulmonary exchange is 69 mmHg, because respiratory gases is nothing but O2 and CO2. O2 partial pressure difference is approximately 64. Carbon dioxide partial pressure difference is 5. Totally both O2 and CO2 partial pressure difference is 64 plus 5, that equal to 69 mmHg. Means in pulmonary exchange, respiratory gases partial pressure difference collectively is 69 mmHg. Personally, oxygen partial pressure difference is 64. Personally, CO2 partial pressure difference is 5. This is the pulmonary exchange. Second one is the systemic exchange. Second one is the systemic exchange. Second type of the exchange of respiratory gases is the systemic exchange. Systemic exchange. This is also called as internal respiration. This is said to be as the internal respiration. This is the second type of the exchange of respiratory gases. What is the systemic exchange means? Just assume this is the systemic artery in which oxygenated blood is circulated. In systemic artery, oxygenated blood is circulated. So that only, what is the PO2 in oxygenated blood means 95 mmHg. What is the PCO2 means 40 mmHg. Definitely in the systemic artery, oxygenated blood is gets circulated. Oxygenated blood is circulated. In oxygenated blood, partial pressure of oxygen is 95 mmHg. Partial pressure of CO2 is 40 mmHg. Again, this is the tissue. This is the tissue or cell. In the case of the tissue or cell, PO2 is 40, PCO2 is 45. Specifically in the case of the tissue, partial pressure of oxygen is 40 mmHg. Partial pressure of carbon dioxide is 45 mmHg. Then near the tissue, from where to where oxygen how to be gets move, from where to where CO2 how to be move means always both oxygen as well as the CO2 moves from their higher partial pressured area to lower partial pressured areas only. So that only oxygen from the systemic artery diffuses into tissue. Oxygen partial pressure is greater in oxygenated blood, that is 95 mmHg, whereas in the tissue that is only 40. So that only oxygen is gets move from oxygenated blood into the tissue. Similarly, in the case of the oxygenated blood, PO2 is only 40, but in the tissue that is 45. So that only CO2 is gets moves from the tissue into the blood. In that way, if the exchange of O2 and CO2, if it is occurs between the blood and tissue, then that is said to be as the systemic exchange, or this is also called as the internal respiration. Definitely, if the exchange of respiratory gases, if it is occurs between the oxygenated blood and tissue of various sites of body, then that is said to be as the systemic exchange or internal respiration. Here, always systemic exchange supply oxygen to various parts of body and convert oxygenated blood into deoxygenated blood. Because oxygen which is present in the blood is moves into the tissue, CO2 which is present in the tissue is gets moves into blood. By that way, oxygenated blood is gradually transformed into deoxygenated blood. Means in this blood, oxygen percent is gradually decreases, CO2 percent is gradually increases. So that only this systemic exchange always convert oxygenated blood into deoxygenated blood. Here also, very important questions for NEET examination point of view. What are the very important questions which may be asked from this particular concept? Means, first question is that, what is the partial pressure difference of respiratory gases? Again, from this particular concept, first NEET question is that, what is partial pressure difference, partial pressure difference of O2 in systemic exchange, systemic exchange is the first question. Second question, what is partial pressure, partial pressure difference of CO2 in systemic exchange is second question. Third question, what is partial pressure difference of, what is partial pressure difference of respiratory gases in systemic exchange, in systemic exchange is third question. First question, partial, what is the partial pressure difference of O2 in systemic exchange? Definitely, how to observe that? In systemic exchange, partial pressure difference of oxygen means, in oxygenated blood that is 95 mmHg, in tissue that is 40. The partial pressure difference of oxygen is nothing but 95 minus 40. 95 minus 40, that equal to 55 mmHg is partial pressure difference of oxygen in systemic exchange. Whereas in pulmonary exchange, partial pressure difference of oxygen is 64 mmHg. In pulmonary exchange, partial pressure difference of oxygen is 64 mmHg. But in the systemic exchange, that is only 55 mmHg. Whereas, what is the partial pressure difference of CO2 in systemic exchange means? Definitely PCO2 is 40 in oxygenated blood. PCO2 is 45. Difference between the 40 and 45 is nothing but partial pressure difference of CO2 in systemic exchange. That equal to 45 minus 40, that equal to 5 mmHg. In both the pulmonary exchange as well as in systemic exchange, the partial pressure difference of carbon dioxide is same. In pulmonary exchange also, partial pressure difference of CO2 is 5 mmHg. In systemic exchange also, partial pressure difference of carbon dioxide is 5 mmHg only, that is same. Partial pressure difference of carbon dioxide is same in both the systemic as well as the pulmonary exchanges. Third question, what is the partial pressure difference of respiratory gases in systemic exchange? Respiratory gases means both oxygen as well as CO2, both oxygen as well as the CO2 partial pressure difference is nothing but third question. What is the partial pressure difference of oxygen in systemic exchange? 55 mmHg. What is the partial pressure difference of CO2 in systemic exchange means 5. So totally 55 mmHg plus 5 mmHg, that equal to 60 mmHg is partial pressure difference of respiratory gases in systemic exchange. 55 mmHg is the partial pressure difference of oxygen. 5 mmHg is the partial pressure of CO2. So partial pressure of both O2 and CO2 together called as the respiratory gases is nothing but 55 oxygen, 5 CO2, totally that is 60 mmHg is the partial pressure difference of respiratory gases. Means in systemic exchange, the partial pressure difference of O2 in systemic exchange is 55 mmHg, whereas partial pressure difference of oxygen in pulmonary exchange is 64 mmHg. Partial pressure difference of CO2 in systemic exchange is 5 mmHg. Whereas in pulmonary exchange also, partial pressure difference of CO2 is 5 mmHg. That is same. Again, partial pressure difference of respiratory gases in systemic exchange is 60 mmHg. Whereas partial pressure difference of respiratory gases in pulmonary exchange is 69 mmHg. So very important question on NEET examination point of view. Totally on both systemic as well as the pulmonary exchange is that, what is the partial pressure difference of respiratory gases in double circulation? What is the partial pressure difference of respiratory gases in double circulation? Another important question on exchange of respiratory gases is nothing but, what is partial pressure difference of respiratory gases in double circulation? In double circulation, double circulation nothing but both systemic as well as pulmonary exchanges together involve in double circulation. Both pulmonary as well as systemic exchanges or gets involved in double circulation. So that only we have to consider the partial pressure difference of respiratory gases in pulmonary exchange and partial pressure difference of respiratory gases in systemic exchange together is the answer for this question. So definitely double circulation nothing but systemic circulation includes systemic exchange, pulmonary circulation include pulmonary exchange, means we have to take the partial pressure difference of both pulmonary as well as systemic exchanges as sum total to get the answer to the question. So definitely pulmonary exchange partial pressure difference of respiratory gases is 69 mmHg. Systemic exchange respiratory gases partial pressure difference is 60 mmHg. So totally that is 129 mmHg is the partial pressure difference of respiratory gases in double circulation. So definitely in systemic circulation, in systemic exchange, partial pressure difference of respiratory gases is 60 mmHg. In pulmonary exchange, that is 69 mmHg. Double circulation means both pulmonary as well as systemic exchanges are involved or include in double circulation. So that only we have to take the sum total of partial pressure difference of respiratory gases in both pulmonary exchange and systemic exchange. That is nothing but pulmonary exchange respiratory gases partial pressure difference is 69 mmHg. Systemic exchange respiratory gases partial pressure difference is 60 mmHg. Totally that is the 129 mmHg is the total partial pressure difference of respiratory gases in double circulation. This is the respiratory gases exchange. One more important point. Pulmonary exchange is always occurs near the lungs only. Pulmonary exchange is always occurs near the lungs only. But systemic exchange is occurs in all areas of the body near the tissue. Systemic exchange is not occurs only in a particular site of the body. Systemic exchange is occurs in all areas of body near the tissue to convert the oxygenated blood into deoxygenated blood, to supply the oxygen from the blood to the tissue. This systemic exchange is occurs in all areas of the body near the tissue. Next topic is transport of respiratory gases. Next topic is transport of respiratory gases. Transport of respiratory gases. What is the transport of respiratory gases means? Oxygen which is reaches to the blood near the lung means from alveoli. Oxygen reaches to the blood. Again, that oxygen have to be transported towards the tissue for its supply. Whatever the oxygen which is reaches to the alveoli, that oxygen must be gets diffuses into blood, and from where that have to be transported to the tissue for its supply, Similarly, in the tissue, due to the oxidation, whatever the CO2 which is gets releases, that CO2 have to be gets transported towards the lung for its expulsion. In that way, O2 have to be gets transported from the lungs, O2 have to be supplied to the tissue. Near the tissue, whatever the CO2 which is gets produced, that have to be supplied to the lung for its expulsion. In that way, blood is acts as the medium. Blood is acts as the medium for the transportation of O2 from the lung to the tissue and CO2 from the tissue to the lung. This is said to be as the transport of respiratory gases. Oxygen always have to be transported to the tissue from the lung